Now, speaking about China, something that many AI researchers didn't predict was that China would catch up with the West in terms of AI development. So how do you feel about that, and what are the consequences?
I don't think they're quite caught up yet. They're very close, though. America's going to slow them down a bit by trying to prevent them having the latest NVIDIA chips. NVIDIA maybe can find workarounds. And what that's going to do, if the embargo is effective, it's just going to cause the Chinese to develop their own technology. And they'll be a few years behind, but they'll catch up. They've got better STEM education than the US. So they've got more people who are better educated. I think they're going to catch up.
Do you know who Mark Andreessen is?
He thinks, yeah, I disagree with him about more or less everything, I think.
Okay, how about let's pick one. So he had a comment that said, I don't understand how you're going to lock this down. He was speaking to someone from the government about how the government was saying, well, if AI development gets out of hand, we can lock it down, quote unquote.
Right.
He was saying, how can you do that? Because the math for AI is out there. It's being taught everywhere. To which the officials responded, well, during the Cold War, we classified entire areas of physics and took them out of the research community. Entire branches of physics basically went dark and didn't proceed. If we decide that we need to, we're going to do the same to the math underneath AI.
Forget it. I agree with Mark Andreessen on that. There's no way you're going to be able to. Now, it could have been, for example, that Google in 2017 could have decided not to publish Transformers. And it might have been several years before anybody else came up with the same idea. So they could slow it down by a few years, maybe. But I don't think there's much hope. Just think what it would take to prevent the information getting out there. It'd be very hard.
So you don't think the government can classify some, what would it be, linear algebra?
No. They could make it harder to share certain kinds of information, which would slow things down a little bit. But I just think it's implausible that they could take AI ideas that really work well, and by not sharing them, prevent anybody else creating them. What happens with new ideas is that there's a zeitgeist, and within that zeitgeist, it's possible to have new ideas. And it often happens that one person has a new idea, and at more or less the same time and quite independently, except they're sharing the same zeitgeist, someone else has a slightly different version of the same idea. This is going on all the time. Unless you can get rid of the whole zeitgeist, you're not going to be able to have new ideas and keep them secret. Because a few years later, somebody else is going to come up with the same idea.
What about decentralizing AI? So that's a huge topic. Some people would say, well, that's giving the atomic bomb to any person who wants access to an atomic bomb.
Yes, I say that.
And then there are other people who say, well, that's what is required in order to create the guardrails against the Skynet scenario, is where we have multiple different decentralized agents or AIs.
Sorry, there's two notions of decentralized. So let's talk about sharing weights. So if you ask, why doesn't Alabama have a bomb? It's because you need fissile material. And it's hard to get fissile material. It takes a lot of time and energy to produce the fissile material. Once you have the fissile material, it's much easier to make a bomb. And so the government clearly doesn't want fissile material to be out there. You can't go on eBay and buy some fissile material. That's why we don't have lots of little atomic bombs belonging to tiny states. So if you ask, what's the equivalent for these big chatbots? The equivalent is a foundation model that's been trained, maybe using $100 million, maybe $1 billion. It's been trained on lots of data. It's got a huge amount of competence. If you release the weights of that model, you can now fine-tune it to all sorts of bad things. So I think it's crazy to release the weights of these big models, because they're our main constraint on bad actors. And Meta's now done it, and other people have followed suit. So it's too late now. The cat's out of the bag. But it was a crazy move.
Well, speaking about foundation models. Much of our latest AI boom is because of Transformer, the Transformer architecture. Do you see some other large breakthrough, either some paradigm or some other architecture on the horizon?
Okay, I think there will be other large breakthroughs of comparable magnitude, because that's just how science works. I don't know what they are. If I knew what they were, I'd be doing them.
Would you, though?
Well, I'm too old now. I have students doing them.
What I mean is, how do you reconcile your past contributions to this field and you have your current woes? So would you be contributing to it?
So here's the issue. AI is very good for lots of things that will benefit humanity a whole lot, like better healthcare, fighting climate change, better materials, things like room temperature superconductors, where AI may well be involved in actually discovering them, assuming there are some out there. So there's so many things, good uses of AI, that I don't think the development's going to be stopped. So I don't think it's sensible to say we should be slowing down AI, slowing down the development. It's not going to happen anyway because there's so much competition. And it's just not feasible. It might be the best thing for humanity, but it's not going to happen. What we should be doing is, as it's being developed, trying to figure out how to keep it safe.
So it's another thing to say that this is a boulder that no one can stop. It's another thing to also be responsible for pushing the boulder as well. So do you actually feel like if there was a breakthrough on the horizon that you see and you could, you're like Ray Kurzweil, you have this great predictive quality, that you would actually put your coins into it and work on it?
As long as that was combined with working on how to keep it safe, yes. I feel I didn't realize soon enough how dangerous it was going to be. I wish I'd realized sooner.
There's this quote from Einstein about the atomic bomb. He said, I would burn my hands had I known what I was developing would lead to the atomic bomb. Do you feel similar?
I don't actually know. Maybe I should. I don't kind of regret what I've done. I regret the fact it may lead to bad things, but I don't think back and think, oh, I wish I'd never done that. I think AI is going to be developed. I don't think we have much choice about that, just because of the competition between countries and between companies. So I think we should focus our efforts on trying to develop it safely. And that's very different from trying to slow down the development.
In addition to alignment, what does safe development of AI mean?
Okay. Figuring out how to deal with the short-term risks. And there's many of those, and they all have different solutions. So things like lethal autonomous weapons. And to deal with that, you need things like Geneva Conventions. And we're not going to get those till nasty things have happened. You've got fake videos and images corrupting elections, particularly if they're targeted at particular people. To deal with that, I think you need a much better system for establishing the provenance of a video or an image. Initially, I thought you should mark them as fake. You should insist they're marked as fake. I don't think there's much future in that anymore. I think you're better off insisting that there's a provenance associated with things and your browser can check the provenance. Just as already with email, it says, don't trust this one, I can't establish it. It should be like that. There's discrimination and bias where you can freeze the weights of a system and measure its bias and then somewhat correct it. You'll never correct it perfectly, but somewhat correct it. So you can make the system less biased than the data it was trained on. And so you can replace people by a less biased system. It'll never be unbiased. But if you just keep replacing systems by less biased systems, that's called gradient descent, things will get less biased. So I'm not so worried about that one, possibly because I'm an old white man. There's jobs. We don't really know what to do about that. So you don't get many people digging ditches anymore because a backhoe is just much better at digging ditches than a person. It's going to be the same for almost all mundane intellectual labor. An AI system is going to make a much better paralegal than a person. that's kind of really scary because of what it's going to do to society. It's going to cause the rich to get richer because we're going to get big increases in productivity. And where's that wealth going to go to? It's going to go to rich people, and poor people are going to get poorer. I don't know what to do about that. Universal basic income helps, stops them starving, but it doesn't really solve the problem because people's dignity is gone if they don't have a job.